Okay, so here we're going to look at a bubble sort algorithm. This is just a code technique for sorting the contents of an array. I have a very small array. I've narrowed it down to just 5 items, just so this doesn't drag on and on and on. And we're going to alphabetize these flavors in the array, A to Z, okay, ascending alphabetical order. And we're going to use a bubble sort to do it. In this video, I just want to do like a visualization of the bubble sort. I'm not going to show any code. I'm just going to show you kind of what's happening behind the scenes when a bubble sort is running. So in a bubble sort, we actually use a nested looping technique. But let's just look at one loop, okay? And this will be very repetitive, what I'm about to do. But imagine a loop starting at the first element, okay, looking at the word coffee and comparing it to the one after it, comparing the value of this element to the one after it. So I'm comparing coffee and brownie chunk, and I'm asking, are these two items out of order, out of alphabetical order? Yes, they are, because B comes before C. So what I need to do is I need to swap these two in their location. So, and this, the swapping is another technique in and of itself. So to swap these two, I have to create some kind of like temporary variable. I'm going to put the coffee in there for safekeeping. I'm going to put the brownie chunk where the coffee was, and then I'm going to move coffee into his new location. So now those two have been swapped, but you have to do it with a temporary variable. Kind of rotate them, almost like volleyball players rotate on a court. Just like, you know, turn them and rotate those values. Okay, so that was the first element. Now I'm moving on to the second element, second iteration through the loop, looking at coffee, okay, in his new location, comparing this value to the one after it, coffee and salted caramel. Are they out of order alphabetically? No, they are not. C comes before S, and so we're going to have them stay put. They're going to stay where they are. Moving on to the next element, salted caramel. Comparing him to the one after him, vanilla. Are these two out of order alphabetically? No, they are not. And so they're going to stay put. Okay, moving on to the next one, next iteration. Comparing vanilla to the one after him, chocolate swirl. Are these two out of order alphabetically? Yes, they are. And so we're going to swap them. Put vanilla in the temp for safekeeping. Chocolate swirl goes where vanilla was. Vanilla goes into his new location. Okay, so that was one pass through the array. And we used a loop to pass through the array. Are our values in alphabetical order? No, they're not. Okay, they're closer than what they were, but they're still not completely in alphabetical order. And so that's where the nested looping comes in. What I just did was like one loop, one pass through the loop, but I'm going to have to do that possibly multiple times. I'm going to have to loop the loop or repeat that repetitive thing I just did multiple times. And that's where the nested looping comes into play. So in the next video, we're going to look at the code with the nested loops and see what a bubble sort looks like in code.